Okay, so before I get into this video, I just want to say thank you to Scribble73 for making this horrendous intro. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
You get me? Man's not hot. I said man's not hot. The thing goes skraa.
You haven't been on the internet this month if you haven't seen this. But for those of you that haven't been on planet Earth this month, this is Michael Dapper, and he went on fire in the booth as his character Roadman Shaq, and it was just great. And this clip got massive. This clip changed this man's life. Like, he's legit going on tours and stuff now for pretty much imitating a gun sound. But I mean, good on him. It was fucking brilliant. But of course, since this clip got so massive and is so easily memeable, people took to the internet in force to make some memes. And I mean, the large majority of them were pretty good. But some were just bad. What does this even mean? But aside from Roadman Shaq, Korean Billy, you know the guy who did the Roadman dialect words?
So bait farm, you ate my chicken nuggets, innit?
Yeah, he did a sort of spin-off of Fire in the Booth called Water in the Booth, where he stands in some bloke's shed and I can't even say spit bars, really. Like, I really don't know what this is.
I've got mandans. We're going on the chicken nuggets. Yo, yo. Chicken nuggets, painting chicken nuggets. Everybody loves chicken nuggets, so we're going on a chicken nugget bus.
Someone sign this man. I know he rhymed chicken nuggets with chicken nuggets 5 times, but still, that doesn't matter. I know true talent when I see it.
Chicken nuggets.
Wanna join my free gift card giveaway?
Right, Dove. That kid that made the fidget spinner and calling boss baby videos a few months back.
Come on, dude. Connecting.
And then got terminated. To be fair, I was pretty devastated when that happened. I never ran out of video ideas when Derv was around. But recently, he briefly made a comeback to YouTube before transforming the channel into a channel called Best Raps for some reason, where the only video is a video called Proof Cardi B is a Freak. All right, Derv. But during his short comeback, he dropped a diss track on a few YouTubers, which has since been deleted, but fortunately, someone has re-uploaded it, so we can watch it in all its glory.
After hearing this diss track, none of you will ever have the guts to scold me ever again. All of you, Leafy, Pyro, Memeulous, Will Ernie, I'm Alex, bow down to the king of YouTube.
Right, so basically the video entails him standing on his mum's roof in a BAPE hoodie and shorts and one of them Gucci tees that looks like something you get from a dodgy Turkish market, but they actually cost a few hundred quid. Like, why? But the disses in this video are just bad. Like, it's arguable if you can even call them disses.
Your name be Pyro, well, after this you will be saying bio.
Right, okay then, Dove. But in the original video title, he put my name in there, and he mentioned me at the start of the video, even though he didn't diss me in the video. But what's all that about then?
Bye, CPMB 3 times yours, probs why you're all gonna stay poor.
Mate, you're literally flexing about 10 quid there. Right, nice one, Dove. Go buy yourself a KFC or something. You've earned it.
And to all my flipping haters, just go back to being skaters.
What does that even mean? And then at the end of the video, he brings out a Gucci bag with like a t-shirt in or something, and then looks as though he's about to burn it.
I'll see you guys in the next video.
Cool, you're really impressing me here, Dove.
What's 9 plus 10?
21.
Okay, so Facebook was on a bit of a mad one last month. First of all, we had the hurricanes that happened in America and the Caribbean, but the people that lived there didn't need to worry because the people of Facebook have found a way to stop the hurricane. Everyone turn on your fans and point it at Irma. But if that didn't work, they had a few other plans. Spin your fidget spinners at Hurricane Irma to push it away. Naruto run away from Irma. And finally, the last resort, twerk Irma away. And then this video pops up on my Facebook and I don't know how old it is, but I saw it last month, so I'm counting it. But it's essentially this video of an Irish kid giving a little message to who I'm guessing is his girlfriend.
I love you. I love you, Rose. If you want to have it, we have it.
Oh, but pure Romeo and Juliet this. Like, first of all, he tells her that he loves her, and then he looks behind him to make sure his mum's not there and asks her if she wants a shag. Romance at its peak.
My name is Patrick Ward. This is going out to all the other girls. on Facebook, a man like me is number one.
I fucking love this kid. Like, it was only a few seconds ago that he confessed his love to this other girl, and now he's sending a message out to all the other girls on Facebook. What a player. But you know when you watch a video and you think it can't get any better? Like, it keeps steadily getting better, and then at a certain point you think, surely this can't get any better. Surely this is the peak. Well, this isn't the peak of the video. It gets better.
A man like me is number one.
What a king. Also, right, imagine being this kid's mum, just going on Facebook, looking at, like, minion memes or whatever it is mums do, and you see that your son posted this. Like, as a parent, what would you even do? Also, last month on Facebook, we had this guy called Sylvester make a post saying, "Do you want me to boost your funeral? Hire me, the professional mourner, to come and cry at your funeral." What I want to know is, how do you become a professional mourner? Like, how do you go down that career path? I mean, I cry myself to sleep every night. Does that qualify me to be a professional mourner? Below are the summer specials price. It's September. Normal crying, $50. Bohemian hollering, $100. Crying and rolling on the ground, $150. Crying and threatening to jump into the grave, $200. Crying and actually jumping in the grave, $1,000. And then he attaches two pictures of himself crying. When I die, I'm gonna put a grand aside just so this guy can come to my funeral.
I'm in my mum's car. Broom, broom.
Right, so last month, TfL announced that they won't be renewing Uber's license in London. And understandably, everyone in London was a bit upset. Because even though Uber are appealing this at the moment, and people in London can still use Uber throughout the appeal process, if Uber loses their appeal, everyone's going to either have to trek to the underground station, or go bankrupt because black cabs charge about 35 quid to go 10 centimetres. But fear not, because Uber has been saved by Coombs. Do you remember Coombs?
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Coombs. Today, I'm going to be doing part two for baiting out pagans.
Yeah, he made a song trying to save Uber. And I mean, if that album art alone doesn't save it, then nothing will. I see Roadman, tell my bitch, book an Uber. Yeah, nah, Uber's fucked.
Catch me outside.
Okay, so that girl that was rude to her mum and told some people to catch her outside signed a very generous record deal recently. You know when people were saying 2016 was the worst year ever? Yeah. But her first song's called These Hoax, and I've heard a lot of people say that they think it's good. And to those people that think that, are you okay? These hoes be fake flossing. Nah, Dove did it better. But she's got a second song called High Bitch with the T removed. She knows how to get around the apocalypse, I'll give her that. And it's marginally better than the last one. Not by much, though. White J's, white Porsche, white wrist. Okay, can I just say, this is possibly the strangest, like, celebrity career I've ever seen. Like, she started off by being rude to her mum, going on Dr. Phil and telling some people to catch her outside, and now she's got a record deal. And to be fair, props to her. She outlived the meme. Like, where's the 21 kid and my name is Jeff today? Nowhere. But in the middle of this song, it suddenly switches to another song called What You Know, and this one's alright. What you know about it? Born cars. What you know about it? What you know about it? Wow, this is actually listenable.
Don't ever judge a book by its cover.
Okay, so there was a trend going around last month, and it's where people made videos saying never judge a book by its cover. And it's pretty difficult to explain, so I'm just going to show you it. But just be warned, this is one of the most brain-dead trends I've ever seen.
Alright, wait, did you think I was really going to cut my eyebrows? Shave my eyebrows? Well, you were wrong. Don't ever judge a book by its cover.
What do you even mean? You have shaving cream on your left eyebrow and had a razor to it. What was I supposed to expect you to do? Do a kickflip on a scooter or something? And there are loads of these.
Oh, did you think I was gonna cut my hair?
Yes, you are holding scissors to your hair.
Don't ever judge a book by its cover.
Chicken nuggets is like my family.
Okay, now last month we were blessed with one of the best headlines I've ever seen. It comes to us from the Daily Mirror and it reads, "Sick paedophiles are pretending to be chicken nuggets online to lure kids." How? Like, is there just a nonce sat somewhere like, right, I could pretend to be a 13-year-old girl. Actually, no, I'll just be a piece of breaded chicken. Like, I know someone on Twitter's already said this, but if your kid starts talking to a chicken nugget online and then goes to meet up with the chicken nugget, it's just natural selection at that point. Right, but anyway, that's the end of today's video and I hope you did enjoy it. If we could get 35,000 likes on this video, then I'll go on fire in the booth. Also, if you're new around here and enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing. The channel just hit 700k the other day, so let's see if we can get 1 million by the end of the year. I mean, that's a bit ambitious, isn't it? But still. But as I said, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to subscribe and smash that like button.